of the Lord.
Amen.
May God continue to be your shepherd.
Amen.
A shepherd never loses focus of his sheep. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says we have a great shepherd. His name is Jesus, our Lord and our Savior.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We thank God. Put your hands together for our great shepherd. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Put your hands before the Father and say after me, say, Father, I thank you that I honor you because you are my shepherd. And I know that I'm in the right grace. I'm in the right grace in the name of Jesus. Therefore, I know that no weapon shall against me shall prosper. Every plan of the enemy shall come to nothing. In Jesus' name, amen. May be seated in his presence. Hallelujah. We just want to welcome those who are watching us for the faithfulness. We just want to welcome you and let you know that we love you and we pray for you regularly. Amen. Church of God, I appreciate it tonight. I love it with your family. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I have been helping some sisters and in my helping them, counseling them out, guiding them in the word of God. From last month, the Holy Spirit has been arresting me on the message of restoration. And I know that the pandemic has probably disrupted a lot of people in many ways. And as I've been looking at the word of God, God has been saying restoration, restoration, restoration. Amen. So I want to take you on a journey, title my message, Faith for Restoration. Amen. Faith for Restoration. We all need to be restored somewhere. Some people have lost people. Other people have lost property. Other people may have lost jobs, may have lost finances or business. God is still a God who restores. Amen. And we believe what God says in his word is true. He is able to restore. There are people who probably were praying for restoration many years ago. And just when they thought the doors were opening, and then the enemy came in and slammed the door shut. I want you to know that the God we serve is still the God of restoration. You can be restored in the midst of the pandemic. You can be restored any time. God does not have a season or a time. Amen. He's a God of restoration. That is part of his attribute. Glory be to Jesus. So as we have known and understood that Jesus is alive, he is seated on the right hand side of God the Father for one of the purposes of our restoration. He is there to intercede for us. His intercession is also about restoration. Restoration talks about bringing us in the position where we're supposed to be, in the grace of God. So as we started 2021, in the grace and in the anointing and in the glory, we should continue in the glory, the grace, and complete it in the same glory. Hallelujah. That means as children of God, we can always live in restoration. We can always appreciate and trust God for restoration. Amen. So let's go to the word of God and just speak a few scriptures from the book of Joel. The book of Joel emphasizes restoration so much. At this particular time, the prophet had known that the people of God needed restoration in many areas of their lives. He had seen how the people of God were suffering, and as he was waiting upon the Lord, God spoke to him that he was going to restore his people. And we are also his people. That means we are candidates for that restoration. I don't know what you have lost. I want you and I to believe together for restoration. Praise the name of Jesus. The Bible says if two agree here on earth, it will be agreed in heaven. So if we agree for restoration, God will definitely restore us. Amen. So the agreement part, we must sort it out and say we agree together in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. As I was praying by grace, God, the Lord reminded me that some people need to be restored back in their right places. And I have done this before in the past. And so next week, I'm going to be doing motivation on getting a job. I'm going to be doing job motivations. And we believe that the people that will come who are trusting God for jobs, they will be restored. All right. So Joel chapter 2, God now is speaking. Verse 25, he says, I will restore, not destroy, not continue to see the way you are growing, the way you are going in life and not have anything, but to restore. That means to bring back what you have lost. That means God wants to do something concerning what you have lost. So he says, I will restore to you the years that the locust has eaten. After the locust ate, the cankerworm also came to destroy. Then the caterpillars came, and then the palmer went, and the great army that was sent and released due to sin, due to evil, or whatever we did that was called iniquity before God. But now God is standing in a position to say, I have forgiven you, I will restore you. I have seen your change, your desire, I have seen your love for me, I will restore. It's a guaranteed promise. He didn't say, I may. He didn't say, I'll see what I can do. He said, I will restore. Somebody's being restored in this year, in this place, in Jesus' name. Then he says in verse 26, and you shall eat in plenty and be satisfied and praise the name of the Lord your God. That has God wondrously with you, and my people shall never be ashamed. Say, shame is not my portion. Say, in 2021, I shall not see shame. I shall not encounter shame. I shall not encounter shame. Shame financially, shame health-wise, shame in the world, shame by sickness, shame by disease. I shall not encounter it in my business and in my life. Glory be to Jesus. Verse 27, and you shall know that I am. Somebody say he is. Say he is. Say my God is. What does the word I am mean? It means God is able. Hallelujah. It says, I am. When somebody says, I am, you expect them to mention their name. All right? But God says, I am in the midst. I am the God in the midst of Israel. That means God is in our middle, in the pandemic. If you love God, God is the middle of your situation right now.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And that I am the Lord your God and none else. And my people shall never be ashamed. Again, a repetition.
Yes.
Jesus was always emphasizing, he would say, verily, verily. Amen. That means pay attention. God is also doing the same here. He's saying it that my people shall never be ashamed. And again, he repeats it. So he is emphasizing so that we may pay attention that we will not go through shame. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. So, restoration is part of a child of God's desire. It is our desire. Everyone who gives their life to God, they do that because they are trusting God for restoration. Amen. So, God is able to restore. I don't know what you have lost. You might be saying, you know, I have lost so much. God is able to restore. And he gives us a promise in the scriptures. He says, I will restore you. So what is restoration? Restoration is the solution to what a man has lost.
Amen.
Restoration is the solution to somebody going through shame. Restoration is the answer to the life of a broken individual. Restoration is the answer to the years that you have lost. Restoration is the solution for your future. When you are restored, you can look into your future and you can say, I thank God he has restored me. Amen.
Amen.
Restoration is the supply of God for all that we need. So when we say God is faithful, amen, we are saying the faithful God is also a restorer. Some of you, maybe you are watching me, you used to pray the prayer, God restore me. It looked like it's too long, and then you gave up, you stopped praying that prayer. I want to encourage you that the same God who said, I will restore you, He's still waiting for you to continue to knock on that door of restoration so that you may move into a different grace. You may move in a higher level. Whether you've lost a job, whether you've lost a business, whatever it is, God is a restorer.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I said God is a restorer.
Amen.
I said God is a restorer.
Amen.
So he is still able to restore us. I'm looking for my restoration. I don't know about you.
Amen.
Amen. So God is able to restore us. He has said in his word. He has said to the people of Israel, in this case it is us, I will restore. It's a divine promise. It's a promise you can work with. It's a promise you can stand on. Every day you say, God is going to restore me. You are walking, you say, God is going to restore me. You are not having enough money, you say, God is going to restore me. You look at your bank account, you say, God is going to restore me. You look at your business, you say, God is going to restore me. It's a promise that he has said. And the Bible says, God is not man that he would lie or change his mind. Hallelujah. So God is going to restore us as his children. He is going to restore every child of God who believes in this promise and in this way.
Amen.
Amen. So our journey of experiencing God's faithfulness includes restoration. If we are going to experience God's faithfulness, it includes restoration. You cannot say, God has restored me, you reach December, and when you look back, you say, I never had joy, I have joy now. Plus the joy that God will give you, you will also see restoration in various areas. Hallelujah. And I'm going to close by two specific areas that the enemy steals in everybody's life. Those will be the areas that will be praying for and trusting God for restoration. Hallelujah. So restoration is the door to moving into a good life. Restoration is the door into which God says, this is where you're supposed to be going and not the other direction. Restoration can bring beauty in your life. Restoration can bring glory in your situation. Restoration can bring you to a point of enjoying the abundance life that Jesus talked about. And we are going to pray and declare God to restore us. Because as we know, he is a good shepherd, according to the word of God. So being a good shepherd, he is able to restore. You may have lost your life, you may have lost your direction, you may have lost your mind, you may have lost somebody in life. God will restore you by this grace coming upon you in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
I can remind you of people in the Bible. One of them was a young man by the name Joseph. Joseph was a young man, innocent. He was victimized by his own family, and then he was thrown into slavery. For many years, Joseph was in slavery, and his family was separated from him. Maybe you are separated from your family by the pandemic. But the story of Joseph is that God restored Joseph. He elevated him, and he also was able to bring back his family. So your separation tonight, your separation by this pandemic is not a separation from the restoration of Jehovah.
Amen. Amen.
The enemy's restoration, the enemy's separation of you and your father and your mother or your brothers and your siblings is not a separation of your restoration. God will intervene like he did in Joseph. Joseph ended up in prison, innocent. I don't know what prison you are going through, but God is able to take you out and restore you.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
I want to give you a few pillar points, and then we'll be finished tonight. Number one pillar point, how does God restore us? By digesting the word.
Amen.
By digesting the word. So we as children of God, as we hear, God has said, I will restore you. We stay there and digest it. God has said, you will restore me. Then we look for areas where we need to be restored. It is pointless to just hear God will restore me and you sit and do nothing. You digest that. So when you do, you know the areas of your restoration and you say, God, you are going to restore me. You start to smile, you start to enjoy your life, you start to build yourself on that word of restoration. Why does God restore? Because he is a covenant God. He cannot break his word. Because when he looks at you, he knows you are weak and he is strong. When he looks at you, he knows you need him to intervene in your situation. So we digest the word. We live in the word. Because the word will help you to stand firm in your faith, to know that God will restore you.
Amen.
The word is a carrier of restoration. The word is a grace for our restoration. The word is everything for a child of God. The word protects us. So when God says, I will restore you, you stand on that word and you declare that the word has been spoken, God will restore me. The thing that the devil wants to steal from the child of God is the word. If the enemy steals the word of God from you, he knows he'll get you. But once you have the word, you are digesting the word, you are eating the word, like a hungry person. A hungry person will go out there looking for food. When you are hungry, you will go and look for food. You will go and look at the house of a cousin. You know there is food. Amen. You will go, if you've got money, go and buy the food. So any hungry person will always look for food. The same with the child of God. We look for the food in the Bible. We look for the food in the word of God in order to digest it, to eat the word, and say, God, I thank you for restoration. So we search the word restoration in its entire meaning, and we know various words that are related to restoration, and also various areas that are related to restoration. May God restore somebody in this house.
Amen.
May God restore somebody watching me. I pray for you this afternoon that as I preach to you, the word will come with life in your situation, in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So a hungry person will look for food. And when they find the food, they will eat it. A child of God will look for food in the Bible. When they find the word in the Bible, they will chew on it. They will eat it. And they will live on it. They will digest on it. And they will know that this is good food for a human being. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jeremiah chapter 15. Verse 16. Jeremiah chapter 15 and verse 16. The Bible says, your words I found and I did eat them. So Jeremiah was also hungry like we are for restoration. Some of you, you are hungry for healing. You are hungry for breakthrough in your business. You are hungry for promotion. Whatever it is, Jeremiah looked for the food that would satisfy him. And the Bible says, he says, I found your word. I found your words and I did eat them.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I ate your word. How do you eat the word of God? By staying in the word. When you arrive at a scripture that is related to your issue, you stay there.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You don't just read for the sake of, no, I want to get to the story where Peter was walking on water. If that has no relationship to what you are going through for now, it is not right to read for now.
Mm.
Hallelujah. Amen. So Jeremiah ate the word. And he says, I did eat them. I found the way. Which way did he find? He was going through the word of God. He arrived at a scripture that struck him. When he arrived at that scripture, it hit his heart. It hit his spirit. And he stayed there. Psalms chapter 61, verse 6. For you will prolong the king's life. Then he realized, oh, so God can prolong my life because I'm a king from generation to generation. He stayed there in the word. He digested. He arrived at another scripture wherever in the Bible. For if God is for you, who can be against you? He arrived at specific scriptures and he stayed there.
Amen.
Digested the word. Hallelujah.
Amen.
My desire is that you may know the right scriptures for every situation in your life.
Amen.
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 You may never read the whole Bible and understand it, but you need to have a certain quality of food in your life in order to move forward. You need to have a certain prophetic word operating in your system. So at this time, Jeremiah said, I did it the way. I enjoyed it. Amen. Hallelujah. So he says, the words I found, I did eat them. And your word was into me the joy and rejoicing of my heart. For I am called by your name, O Lord God of hosts. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I ate your words. Then I discovered that you know my name. I discovered that you know my situation. I discovered that you have a promise for me. I discovered that your word is bringing health inside me. I discovered that your word is life. I woke up and decided I will eat the word. When I did that, I became a man of faith, a man of hope. Before then, I was staying in a moody. I was in a situation where I didn't know the way out. But when I ate the word, I found life. I found joy. I found strength. I found ability. I saw my way again. I started to dream again. I saw my focus again. I saw my future by eating your word.
Hallelujah.
By eating your word. He ate the word. Eat the word. Read the Bible. You will arrive at certain scriptures that will surprise you about who you are as a child of God. Hallelujah. So he says, I rejoiced in my heart. Glory be to Jesus. May somebody rejoice in this season. In the name of Jesus. By eating the word of God, may you who thinks that God does not know that God knows you. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Now, Jeremiah ate the word himself. At that time, God will feed you the word in the mouth. Other times you find yourself going through the Bible, you arrive at a scripture that is holding on to your spirit. Other times God will give you the words to eat in your mouth. So the two must operate in your life. When you are hungry, you want to eat. And when you are not necessarily very hungry, but God feeds you. Like a father would have a child, and that child had breakfast in the morning, and the father takes the child to maybe the shop, and he knows the boy has eaten, but the father decides to buy food for the child, and the child eats again.
Hallelujah.
Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 9. Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 9. Then the Lord put forth his hand, and he touched my mouth. And the Lord said unto me, behold, I have put my word in your mouth. I have put my food in your mouth. Jeremiah knew the word of God is food. And now God says, I have put my food, my words in your mouth. So what is Jeremiah supposed to do? Digest them. Hallelujah. Eat the word. Enjoy the word. Live in the word. Let your stomach be a spiritual stomach for the word of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let your stomach be a spiritual stomach for the word of God to settle down there. So he confessed that he digested the spiritual food that God had given him, and also the food that God had prepared that he found and he enjoyed more. So in order to be restored, you need to digest the word. If you have lost something, you stay on that word, digest it, restoration will come to your life.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You open the Bible, and as you do that, the absolute Spirit of God will come into your situation. He will lead you into restoration. You develop to say, God, you have said in your word that you will restore me. He will restore you. I said he will restore you.
Amen.
I said he will restore you.
Amen.
I guarantee you the word of God will restore you.
Amen.
I guarantee you, Jehovah will not lie to you in the mighty name of Jesus. So you develop the desire to say, I will not walk out of my house before I digest my breakfast. Hallelujah. I will not walk out of my house in case when I go there outside, I become hungry. Because when I become hungry now, I'll be looking for the food, and I find I left the food in the house. The word of God. Hallelujah. Amen. So you don't miss your breakfast in the house. You do not miss your breakfast. You don't go out there, you're going to become very hungry, and you left your food in the house. Amen. Jeremiah gave us this insight. As we digest the word, God will do what? Will restore us. May you be restored in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
I said, may you be restored in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Number two, pillar number two. How do we get restoration? By praying in faith. By not just digesting the word, but by praying in faith. Hallelujah. By praying in faith. Believing God that God has said it and it shall come to happen in our land. This is the story of a man who lost a lot of things. His name was called Job. And the Bible says Job lost a lot. Job lost in a disastrous manner. He lost wealth, he lost children, he lost family, he lost everything. And if you were in the time of Job, you would think that God is not there to restore Job. Amen. People may be looking at you and they say, we know where you used to be, but we have seen that you are never going to get there again. It is a lie of the devil.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It is a lie of the devil. God is the restorer. So as we walk and believe, we also pray by faith restoration. By faith. Amen. We make a prayer to say, God, this is what you have done. To Job, Job restored him by prayer. The Bible says, God restored Job and he blessed him. Restoration brings you not to the same level you lost, but to a higher level than where you lost.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Job chapter 42, verse 12. Job chapter 42, verse 12. So the Lord blessed the latter end of Job more than his beginning, for he had 14,000 sheep. You can ask somebody who is selling sheep and tell them, can you multiply 14,000 by whatever the price of a sheep? Amen? We'll give you a figure. And then he had 6,000 camels. Go to somebody who has horses. Ask them the price of one horse and multiply that by 6,000. And he also had 1,000 yoke of oxen. Go to somebody who has got bulls, okay, cow bulls. Ask them, what is the price of one bull? Multiply that by 1,000. And 1,000 she asses. Go to somebody who's got cattle that are bearing, that are giving milk. Ask them, how much is the price of this cow giving milk? Don't forget, a cow giving milk is not just a normal price, because it is also giving milk on top of that. Hallelujah. So to just give us an idea of what restoration is, the Bible says God blessed Job more than his beginning. His beginning looked good. Your beginning may be looking good, but restoration brings you to a higher more than looking good.
Amen.
You didn't hear me.
Amen.
Restoration brings you to a level more than looking good.
Amen.
You were looking good, but restoration brings you higher than you were looking good.
Amen.
Are you here?
Amen.
Are you here?
Amen.
I said, are you here?
Amen.
I declare to you, you shall not perish.
Amen.
You shall not perish in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May every gossiper against you be heavily punished in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May every evil wish against you be punished in the name of Jesus. Because God will bless you like he blessed Job, like he blessed Abraham, like he blessed Isaac and Jacob, God blessed this man called Job more than where he was. I don't know what car you were driving when you lost it. You're going to get a better car.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. I don't know where your finances were, but God is going to take you higher than where you are in your finances. In the mighty name of Jesus. So the Lord blessed the latter end of Job more than his beginning. Praise the name of Jesus. So somebody went there and counted, Job, how many sheep have you got? He said, I've got 14,000. But we also see horses and camels. How many do you have? I have counted today, there were 6,000. I don't know tomorrow, because tomorrow others are giving birth. At the time when they were doing the counting, he had 14,000 sheep, he had 6,000 camels, 1,000 bulls, 1,000 sheep. But don't forget that they were still multiplying. So if you went there the next day, you find they have given more. That's what restoration is. Are you hearing me? That's what restoration is. So you pray and you say, God, let my restoration be like Job. Let my restoration be like Job. If you have 14,000 sheep today, I guarantee you, you count them, you come back to your house. If you come back an hour later, you find the pregnant ones are giving birth. They are increasing. May yours give birth and increase. May yours give birth and increase in the mighty name of Jesus. May yours give birth and increase by the power of the Holy Ghost. So you pray by faith. You pray by understanding. You pray by revelation. You have heard the word of God because your faith needs the word. As you hear the word, the Bible says, you say, Lord, I have faith now. I have heard. I believe for restoration. In the name of Jesus, the enemy will never frustrate you again. Not when you can pray. Not when you know that God wants you to be restored. The devil will never frustrate you. I declare in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So you pray by faith, understanding. You restore Joseph. You restore Job. You can restore me as well in 2021. And God will restore you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
All right, let's look at two areas that I believe you need restoration. You and me. Amen.
Amen.
Two areas. There may be many, but these are prime. Number one is restoration of finances.
Yes.
Restoration of finances. Hallelujah. Joel chapter 2. Verse 22. Joel chapter 2, verse 22. He says, be not afraid, you beasts of the field, for the pasture of the wilderness do spring. For the tree bears her fruit. The tree does what? Gives fruit. The tree produces fruit. Amen. The tree in this case is symbolic of where you are getting fruit. Where are you getting fruit? So your tree may be a business. Your tree may be a saloon. Your tree may be a shop. Where is the supply of your food? That is what the tree is. Hallelujah. The tree will do what? Will bear fruit. I have a few trees at my house. The other day, I noticed that my lemon tree is not giving enough lemons. I stood there, I looked at it. I said, no, this is a lie of the devil. That was some months back. I said, this tree, at one time it gave me big lemons, the size of a fist even bigger. Then I said, Lord, the Bible says the tree bears fruit. I love lemons. I do use lemons. So, on the holiday, yesterday, I passed through to see that tree. And to my surprise, the lemon now has big lemons. The tree has big lemons there. Hallelujah. So the Bible says the tree will do what? Will produce its fruit. For you, your tree may be a saloon, may be a barber shop, maybe a grocery, maybe your job where you are working. The Bible says and declares the tree, your source of enjoyment, your source of finances, your source of breakthrough, it shall bear fruit in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Restoration. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, my business must bear fruit. My business, now declare that you know and that you want it. Say, my business, it shall bear fruit in the name of Jesus. I speak to my business right now and declare by the word of God, Jehovah Almighty, according to Joel chapter 2 verse 22, my business, you are bearing fruit in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. The tree shall do what? Bear fruit. That's when we say you will experience the faithfulness of Jehovah. It means what you never saw bearing fruit will start to give you fruit. You business people, I pray for you every day. And God told me your season has just begun. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Your tree will bear fruit. Your business will produce. The devil may have lied for many years, but God says it shall bear fruit. Shall bear fruit. Why did God use the tree? Because a tree is unstoppable. A tree is stubborn. It can grow where there is rocks. It can grow where there is cement. One day, I happened to be with Pastor Mando. We went around our building. At the back here, we're just looking for dirt. We saw a tree in the corner here. Between a wall, it had come out. I said, Pastor Emmanuel, we have a tree here. You need to cut it out. He says, hey, the trees are difficult, but we'll cut it. He cut it. After 3-4 months, I passed through there. The thing had come up again. So the Bible uses the tree to give you an example that when restoration comes upon you, your blessing is unstoppable. Unstoppable. Like a tree. Nobody can come and say this business is never going to grow. If it is according in alignment to the word of God, that business will produce fruit in the mighty name of Jesus. So by prayer, you say, God, I thank you. My business is like a tree that is productive. It shall bear fruit. That's why the Bible says, in all labor, there is profit. In your labor as a man, you're waking up in the morning, going back home in the evening, there is profit. Maybe you are waking overnight in the night. Your being at work in the night is profitable in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. I declare to you, you shall live an inheritance. You shall live a great inheritance. You shall have a big inheritance. Jehovah will not lie in the mighty name of Jesus. You shall have an inheritance. There will be restoration in your finances in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Somebody say restoration. Say, Father, restore me financially. I declare every enemy of my finances, I scatter you today. I scatter you today by fire of the Holy Spirit. Every enemy of my finances, get out of my life. Get out of my life. I am being restored in the name of Jesus. Every manipulation of Satan in my business, in my finances, I declare war by the fire of the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. My business, my source of income, I command you now by anointing of the Holy Spirit, begin to bring profit, begin to bring profit, begin to bring profit in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The enemy is a liar. Restoration of finances. The reason we live is connected to finances. To get married, you need money. To have a child, you need money. Yes. To live well, you need money. Yes. Whatever you desire, you need money. To have a mic to preach, we need money.
Amen.
To be in a house, we need money. So God must restore us financially.
Amen.
I said, God must restore us financially.
Amen.
The devil has died for too long. God will restore us. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
He will restore us.
Amen.
He will restore us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the name of Jesus. There is profit in your labor. There is profit. You wake up at 4 a.m. when you are supposed to be sleeping. You go to work at 7 o'clock when your little girl is crying, mommy, mommy, you say, I have to go to work. In that sacrifice, there is profit for you.
Amen.
It's profit for you.
Amen.
You are not finding time to serve God as you want to. Your heart is to serve God. But because you have these two kids, you have these three children you must raise, you are saying, God, if you give me a breakthrough, then I will save you. Your breakthrough will come in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Will come. The devil is a liar and a loser. You see, I want to be an evangelist. I wish I could spend all my time just standing and talking to people about Jesus. Just bringing people to the house of God. But you know, I have needs. I have to have my own house. I have to drive here and there. The Bible says your tree will bear fruit.
Amen.
Bear fruit.
Amen.
You're going somewhere.
Yes, sir.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I say one more time, you're going somewhere.
Yes,
in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Number two area of restoration is your health. Your health. These are the two areas the devil lies about. There are many areas, but finance is one of them, and body attack by sickness and disease. That is another lie of Satan. Joel chapter 2, verse 26. And you shall eat in plenty and be satisfied. You see, good food will make you look good. So when the Bible says you shall eat, it is talking about the choice of your food. Amen.
Amen.
If you feed a child with good food, that child will grow well. Good food has something to do with health. When you are eating good food, you will be healthy. Your system recovers because of good food. Hallelujah. There are people who want to put on a little bit of weight. They cannot because of the food. But when you eat good food, you can say, okay, now I put on 2-3 kgs. I think I look good.
Yes,
there are people who want their hair to grow well, but they are not eating the right food.
Yes.
Ah, you're not hearing me. The Bible says you shall eat in plenty. Abundance. You shall have enough food. Food is connected to good health.
Amen.
Good food. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And then the Bible says, then you shall praise the name of the Lord. What will you praise the name of the Lord for? For plenty food.
Amen.
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 Because you have enough food, you will say, God, I thank you. I never go hungry. Hallelujah. So, a life is connected to eating well. If the mother does not have enough food, that child may not have a good health. If an adult is not eating good food as they desire, they may be sick unnecessarily.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So, restoration is also connected to us living well, to us eating well. There are places we don't need healing. All we need is good food.
Amen.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. There is a sickness, if I remember correctly, Pastor Ofer will help me. I think it's called kwashiorkor or something like that. Kwashiorkor means a person who is sick because they are not eating good food. Amen. Am I right?
Yes.
Kwashiorkor. And malnutrition. Amen. It is not a sickness. It's not a disease. It's lack of eating plenty. So God says you will not have nutrition. You will not have kwashiorkor. Because you are eating well. Glory be to Jesus. May you eat well in 2021. May you eat well in 2021. In the name of Jesus. May your body be healthy in 2021. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I finished my Jeremiah chapter 30. Verse 19. Jeremiah was given a lesson he will never forget. And we must also never forget. Jeremiah was not eat the word. Your son, I've given you the word. In chapter 30, verse 17, now he tells him, he says, I will restore your health.
Yes.
I will restore your health. I will heal you of the wounds that are on you.
Hallelujah.
May somebody be healed in their body. I don't care the sickness. May you be healed in the name of Jesus. May somebody's body be in order according to the word of God. May God restore you that as you grow old in age, you will continue to look young and strong in the name of Jesus. Who told you old age is when you reach 40, then you start having a walking stick? Who told you you must be afraid of reaching 80? Because you remember your auntie who at 80 was looking terribly wasted. It is a lie of the enemy. Jehovah says, I will restore your health. I will restore your health. I will bring back your health. I will clean the wounds. I will remove the pain. I will take away the scars in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I was helping a young girl and I told her something about witchcraft, backgrounds of the family. I said, you remember most of us Africans, we went to some of us and they put three marks here. And she said, I used to have them, but they disappeared. The reason they disappeared is because God restored and cleaned the wounds. May God clean your wounds. May God clean your wounds. May He give you life in your heart, perfect heart. In your kidneys, perfect kidneys. In your lungs, operating lungs. In your liver, functioning correctly. Your blood moving from the heart to the top of your head, to the bottom of your feet, in your fingers, in your feet. In the name of Jesus, may you become healthy in Jesus' mighty name. The devil is a liar and a loser. My father died early. I refuse to die at his age. I said, not me. I'm gone beyond. Why? Because God is a restorer. When the devil stole, God can give it back to you in a better form.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
I said, in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Genesis chapter 43, verse 28. I have to give you this one as well. Genesis chapter 43, verse 28. This is the story of Joseph's father. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They answered. They said, your servant, our father is in good health. Our father is what?
In good health.
In good health. Our father is in what?
Good health.
When God restores you, may you have good health.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. Our father is what?
In good health.
Amen.
Amen.
In good health. Not in bad health. Simply, then okay, then no. In good health.
Yes.
Perfect health.
Amen.
No hospital visitation.
No.
Good health.
Amen.
Not having a pharmacy in your own house.
No.
This one for this, this one for that, this one. No. In good health. And God is not a liar. If you live in this way, you digest this way, and you say, Jehovah, Joseph's father was in good health. I can also be in good health.
Amen.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May you be in good health.
Amen.
I declare in the pandemic, may you be in good health.
Amen.
May you be in good health.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. On a daily basis, may you experience good health by the power of the Holy Ghost, I declare, and so shall it be. Can I hear your amen?
Amen.
Can I hear your amen?
Amen?
Father, we bless your name. We worship and honor you because restoration is our portion. You are a God who restores. We believe in restoration. In 2021, restore us. Restore your grace. Restore anointing. Restore businesses. Restore life. Restore breakthrough. Restore that man who has been going through a difficult time. Restore the one who is hopeless. That person who is at the point of committing suicide. Restore them now in the name of Jesus. That woman who just lost their job last month. Restore them in the name of Jesus. That person deciding that they will never again come back to you. Father, restore them that they may come back to you and enjoy the profit of the relationship with you in the name of Jesus. I release anointing for restoration. Every burden be removed. Every yoke be destroyed. Jehovah intervenes now for restoration in Jesus' mighty name. So shall it be. Amen.
Amen.
I'll hear your testimony and testify the glory of God. God bless you.